Hello, this is Ananya. In the last lecture, we studied about inbuilt functions in Python. So we were just getting ready and prepping ourselves to study strings in Python. So today's the day we'll be studying about strings. Basically, we'll be learning a lot about string operations using a lot of practical examples. So let's see what we have in store.
Okay, so we are done with inbuilt functions. We are done with strings. So we know the basics. Now let's combine strings and functions, that is inbuilt functions, and try and explore a lot more about string operations. Okay, so now we all know what a string is, right? We have used it during taking inputs from the user, and we have again printed it. We have tried adding two strings and then printing it. Now we shall see all of that in detail. Okay, so getting to know about all the methods that a string provides us is that is the class string that provides us with. You can just simply type the help function, as we saw last time. You can just say help and pass the string class to it. You can get to know about all the methods that you can apply with string. Okay, now let's look at something very basic. Now each string and each character inside a string can be accessed by two types. Okay, so let's take this example. The sentence is, this is a string. Now from the string, the word this, okay, you see the word this, and inside it you have the letter T. Now instead of printing this entire string, I only want to print this first letter. So what I can say is string of 0. Okay, the string of 0 will give me the letter T. How? Because each character is stored inside this string, starting from the value 0 up to the length of the string minus 1. Okay, so basically the storing starts from the number 0. So string of 0 will give you the first letter, string of 1 will give you the second letter, and so on. So string of 0 gives us T. And now what if I want the last letter? The last letter can be accessed by string of 15. Now why 15? Because if you can count and see, the length of this entire string is 16. It has a total of 16 characters. So since we are starting from 0, the last letter can always be accessed by the length of the string minus 1. That is just one less than the length of the string. Hence, you can access the last letter by string of 15. Now, this is basic, you know, accessing by 0 and the last number. But as I previously just mentioned, that each character can be accessed by two methods. Okay. It each has two values stored for it. So you see, we just access this string by 15. We access G by 15. But I can also say string of minus 1. And I can get G also by saying this. How? Because when we are starting backwards, not forward, but rather backwards, it starts getting stored as minus 1. So you have G stored as minus 1, N stored as minus 2, I is minus 3, and so on. And therefore, the first character which we were accessing with 0 can also be accessed by minus 16. Now why minus 16 and not minus 15? Because we are starting with minus 1 here and not 0. Okay, you cannot have two values as 0, right? You cannot have T as 0 and also G as 0. That's going to be confusing for the interpreter, right? So Python decided to start it with minus 1. and not 0. Okay, so minus 1 up to minus 16. So 0 and minus 16 will give you the first letter, 15 and minus 1 will give you the last letter, and accordingly you can access any character that you want from the middle of the string. So this is sort of string slicing. It's an introductory information to you about slicing of strings. Now slicing is exactly what its literal meaning is. You basically are slicing, like the way we slice an apple, the same way we are slicing a string here. Now this is basically a gist of all the functions that we'll be trying in today's lecture. So you see, you have slicing here, concatenation. We have had some experience with concatenation before. I don't know if you all remember, but no worries, we'll be doing it today again. So this is all that we'll be trying today. So let's just get started. I hope you all have understood this thing. In case not, just pause it and have a look at it. Just try it out with pen and paper. Okay? Alright. Now let's get started. Okay? Again, let's create a new file. As I said, if you all want, you all can just type help str and get to know about all the types of methods you can perform with strings. Okay, now let's try our first example. Now Python provides us with a function named as split, and you can use split with strings. Okay, now maybe split is will be totally new to you in case you're not already familiar with Python. So maybe starting with split will be a little difficult for you, so let's just start with simple ones. Okay, we just saw the basics of slicing. Now let's try out a simple function such as count. Okay, now what count will do is, if you want to count the occurrences of a certain word or a certain character, you can pass that inside the count function, and it'll basically give you the count of like the number of occurrences of that character of that word. So let us give a string such as the apple is rotten. Again, the apple must not be eaten. Okay? This is our sentence, and now what I want to do is, I want to see how many times the word apple is occurring here. So what I do is, I say print strings dot, okay, strings c. You all might notice this, after you put the dot here, you get all the types of methods that you can apply. It gives you all the methods possible. Okay, you have everything here, you can go through it, and also we'll be seeing many of these examples in this lecture and also the upcoming lecture. So I say strings.count, and inside I give the character or the word apple. Okay, let's see what it gives us. You have 2. Why 2? Because you have apple occurring twice here. Okay, as simple as that. So strings.count gives us the number of occurrences of that character or word. So we saw count. Now let us check is alpha. Now I shall again say, what is alpha is, does that every character should be a letter in the string. Okay, if that is satisfied, then the isAlpha function will return as a boolean value that is true. Now we can see here everything is a letter, so let's try this out. So print strings dot is alpha. See, you already have it for you here. Just click on it. And that's it. You run it. It gives you false. Now, why false, you might wonder? Because I just said that everything is a character here. It should give us true. Now, the reason is you have spaces here. Now, these spaces are not treated as letters, right? So, hence, you are going to get this as false. Now, let me try another string which holds only a single word. Okay? Now, I'll say print strings dot is alpha, and I shall also print the second that is string we took str2, right? Okay. See, you get a true here because it does not have any spaces. So how can we get this sentence to be true? What we can do is alpha numeric. Okay, is alpha numeric. Let's try this. Maybe it gives us true this time. Why not? Because you do not have any number here. Alright. So it needs a string that contains both characters, that is letters and numbers. Now we finished with is alpha. Let's give a digit and let's try out these two apples are rotten. Okay, the apples must not be eaten. Now let's see what we get. And let's make this is alpha. So we get a false here. All right. Since we have a digit here. Now what we do is we saw count is alpha, then now we shall see is lower. Now what is lower does is it basically checks if all the letters in the string are lowercase letters. If so, then it will return us true. So we say print strings dot is lower. Okay, so let's see what it gives us. It gives us false. Why false? Because we have two capital letters here, that is T. Okay, now let's try out using string 2 because everything is small here. It gives us true. Why? Because everything is in the lower case here. Now let's try the upper case, that is upper. Everything here, it's just the opposite. Everything should be in the uppercase. Let's make this apple all capitals. It gives us true. Okay. Now let's make this A small. It gives us false. Okay. Now let's try out a few more other functions. Let's make, now we checked if it is lower or upper. Now let us make, you know, the string as completely lower or upper. All you have to do is type lower. So we are making string 2 completely in the lower case. See, you get everything in the lower case. Similarly, you can apply for upper. I don't have to do it here. Now we shall try another thing. For example, I have spaces here, okay? I have spaces before and after the word apple. Now I want to remove these spaces. What I do is I simply say L strip. Okay? The strip function will, L strip rather, the left strip will remove these spaces for you. So I say string 2, L strip. Okay. See, it removed. Maybe you're not able to understand it. I'll just print string 2 here, then you can understand the difference. See, you have these spaces here. You have them after also. I'll just give a character A. It's clearly readable then. See, in the first string, we haven't removed anything. So you have all the spaces, the white spaces, just as it is. And now when we said L strip, it removed the beginning spaces for us. Similarly, if I want to remove the right spaces, it basically removes the spaces for you here. Just hold on. You have the right spaces removed for you. You won't be able to notice that. Now if I want to remove both the left and the right strip, okay, I simply say strip. It removes both of them for us. It basically removed the left and the right side, okay. So this is how you can strip white spaces. Okay, so now we have seen quite a lot of functions using strings. Now let's get a little more complicated. We were talking about split, right? So let's look at that now. So what I want to do with split is, I have a sentence, okay? Let me remove all of this. And let me say sentence is equal to, the bird is hatching eggs in its nest. The bird is hatching eggs in its nest. Now what I want to do is, I want to separate these words in a certain range, okay? Now range won't be the correct word. I want to, after certain spaces, I want to separate it. I do not want it being an entire complete sentence. So what I do is, I use the split function. Now let me just type it for you and then I'll explain it. So I say print sentence.split and I say space and 4. Now let's see, understand what is going on. Now inside the split function, I provide these two parameters. Now what the first parameter means is, when you shall separate the sentence according to spaces, okay? Whenever you see the first space, split the sentence. And you shall do this 4 times. So the interpreter gets the first space, it splits the first word and makes it separate. That is, it becomes the and then the remaining sentence. Then after encountering bird, it meets the second space. Now you have basically 3 sentences. That is the, bird, and then you have is hatching eggs in its nest. And so on, it'll do it 4 times. And the answer will be given to you in the form of a list. Let's see it. There you go. You have the separated, then you have bird is hatching. So it did it 4 times, okay? It did the splitting 4 times. And after that, when it encountered the space, that is after hatching, it was done splitting 4 times, and hence the remaining of the sentence stays the way it is. So basically you get 5 parts from this same sentence. This is how split function works. We shall be looking and trying out a little more complex splitting in the next lecture. Alright. So I think we already tried out length of a string previously. If not, let's just try it out again. I want to say print the length of the string. So it gives you 37. So there are a total of 37 characters in this sentence. Now let us try on concatenate strings, okay? Maybe I have another sentence, that is sentence 2, and this holds the string. It looks so pretty. It looks so pretty. And now what I want to do is, I want to concatenate sentence 1 and sentence 2 to form a single sentence. So how do I do that? Let me take a variable concatenate, or just con, and inside that I shall say sentence plus, I shall give a space also, and now I shall say sentence 2. So what it basically does is, I am concatenating the strings here using the addition operator. Okay, you all might have seen this when we were using print statements, whenever we had to print the certain string. So we say this is a string, and then we say plus, and then we give the variable. So we have already seen concatenation of strings here. We'll just doing it explicitly again here. So we are saying sentence 1 plus space plus sentence 2. And now let me print it. Let's see what we get. I'll comment the previous ones now that we're done with it. It's not necessary. See, you get the entire sentence as one whole. I didn't give a full stop after nest. Let me just do that. See, you have a complete sentence. Okay? So this is how concatenation works. Now, there is another thing where you can format strings. Okay? Now, formatting strings is pretty simple. Now, let's just have a look at it. Formatting basically means you are providing certain variables, and using curly braces, you are providing keywords inside it so as to give the output required. You are not explicitly formatting it the way we did it. You are asking the interpreter or the compiler to do it by itself. So let's try a simple example. Okay, let me take a first name and surname as two variables. So I have F name is equal to, maybe let's just take an example, A, and the surname of A will be Z. Okay, now what I want to do is, I say print, okay, then I say F. Okay, this is one sort of formatting for string. Okay, this is basically the type F string. So basically format the string. You have many different ways to format strings, but we shall just look at this one in this video and then go ahead with another example in the next video. So I say F, hello, my name is, and now what I do is, inside curly braces, I say F name, that is, I pass the variable F name, and then I give a space, and then again I say surname. Okay, let's look at the syntax properly once again. I given the letter F, that is F string, so F, and inside double quotes, I give my string, hello, my name is, and using curly braces, I give the variables inside which I stored my the names, okay, basically the strings. Let's run this. So you get, hello, my name is AZ. So if we weren't doing formatting, what we previously would have done is print hello, my name is, and then we would have given the plus operator, and then we would have said fname, and then again give a space and separated with the plus sign again. Then we had to do a lot of work, right, for that. Let's run this. It's going to give you the same output. Okay, sorry, I gave that in double quotes. See, you get the same thing, but I missed my again. You are getting exactly the same thing, but this you've got to do a lot of work, you know, and you have to be careful. You have to give the plus operators properly, give the space. Instead of that, you just simply can type this sentence and your string gets formatted. Okay, so this is one way of formatting strings. We shall look into various others in the next video. So F string, this is of the type, let me just give it F string. Okay, and I'll show you all another way of printing strings. I'll say print hello, my name is, and then I say mod s and mod s. S basically stands for string. Okay, now I separate the string to be printed with a mod sign, and in parenthesis I give f name comma surname. Okay, so what I did here is I said mod s, so this mod s gets assigned to f name and the second mod s gets assigned to surname. Let's run this. You get hello, my name is AZ. So you see here we saw three different types. The first one was just basic printing, and the second two types were formatting of strings. All of them give you the same output. Okay, now we have done a lot regarding strings, getting to know all the basic functions. So for this video, I think we should stop, give a little rest to our heads and not jumble it up too much. Okay, so that's all for today. We have done functions and string functions. We have tried out various examples. If you want, just try out some more examples by yourself, like you have a few more. And in the next video, we'll be doing a little complex functions and a little complex programs, such as slicing, then splitting, replacing, joins. And we're going to have a little bit of fun with strings. All right. So I guess that's it. All right. Bye-bye. See you soon.